Hey folks, and thanks for joining us for another one of these pop-up webinars. My name is Sebastian Bleek, and in a little bit we're going to be joined by Nicholas Vanderwall, founder of Astute Graphics. So today what we're going to be doing is we're going to be going over ColliderScribe 2 and the new feature Space Fill. Now the way this guy works is if you take a look over here on my screen, I've got two shapes ready to go. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to use a large shape as a container, and this smaller shape, I'm going to use this to fill in the space inside of this container. Now, once it fills in that space, we're going to be able to have a variation on our rotation. We'll have multiple copies. We could have a variation on the size, all kind of stuff like that. And all these things can be controlled by a panel. Now, the panel you want to bring up is a space fill panel. You can find this panel by coming over here to the window menu, scrolling down until you find ColliderScribe, and then see right here where it says space fill panel. You want to click on that, and it's going to bring up the space fill panel. It looks just like your normal panels, like the ones you're used to working with in Adobe Illustrator. Now, if I select both of these shapes, you see I have access to this button at the top that says Make. So when I click on that, it's going to make a space fill object for me. Take a look over here in the upper right. I have my appearance panel up already, and it says in there space fill, and that's how you know that you have a live space fill object that can be controlled by this panel over here. Over on the left, you might have already noticed my artwork kind of changed up a little bit. So some things are going on in there. We have a variation on the size and the rotation, and we have multiple copies in there. And like I said earlier, all that stuff is being controlled right here in the panel. So let's go through this one bit at a time. Over here at the top, it says release and expand. We have two different buttons set up. Now, when I click on release, it's actually going to release that space fill object, and it's going to give you back the original shapes that you started off with. And check this out, it even dropped off this fill shape in the original location that we started off in. All right, so I'm going to click Make just to make another space fill really quick. And next, I'm going to click on Expand. So, all right, when we click on Expand, it's the normal expand that you're used to working with in Adobe Illustrator. Check this out in the Appearance panel over in the upper right. Now it says Group. Remember earlier it said Space Fill? Now, over here with our artwork, if I double click on this guy a couple times, you notice that this is just a group made up of shapes that are just created using regular anchor points and paths. So it's all normal stuff that you're used to working with in Adobe Illustrator. So I just went back a couple steps so I could bring back my space fill object. And that's how these two buttons work. So release is going to give you back your original objects, and expand is actually going to burn in those changes that you made using space fill. Both of these buttons are actually going to get rid of your space fill object. All right, next we have this section over here that says seed, and then we have this series of numbers, and then we have this button over here that says randomize. And every time I click on randomize, you see we're going to have a new seed value in here, and our artwork is going to change. So let's see what's going on over here. All right, so it says seed value used to create random positioning. Now, when we're dealing with this in computers and stuff, we don't have like a true randomization, right? So what we're doing here with the seed value is we're creating a pseudo randomization, all right? Now, every time you change this value, you're going to get a new variation. So I'm going to click randomize, and then you see the artwork is updated. Now, the cool thing about this for you designers out there is, what if you fall in love with a specific rotation or some kind of variation to your artwork, you know, that you get a cool randomization? You could actually come in here and make a copy of these settings and then use them again whenever you need them. So it's a pseudo randomization, but it's going to help us out. We're going to get cool looks that we could use again and again. All right, next we have method. And currently mine is set to centers. That's usually what I have mine set up as. It says each piece of filling art is spaced using just its center point. All right, over here to the right, we have outlines. And it says each piece of filling art is spaced using its actual outline, and this is a little bit slower. Now, the reason it's slower is it's going to be more RAM intensive because we're actually going to be using the edges of the artwork. Over here for centers, we're just going to be focused on the center point, so it's going to move things along a lot quicker for us. All right, so most of the time I am going to be working with centers, but in a little bit I'm going to show you a workflow, basically a way to set up your settings over here, so you can work a lot easier with outlines or even a document that is like a really large document that's really RAM intensive. All right, next we have uniformity, and we have this slider associated with it, so I could click and drag to increase that value, and you notice we max out at 10. All right, we could also come in here and enter in a specific value. I'm gonna enter in 5, and then we also have this increment button and decrement button, so we can make whatever changes we need. I'm gonna max this guy out at 10 because I want to get things a little bit more uniform in here. All right, next, We have resize all filling art. Now I'm going to turn some of these guys off really quick and then go back to resize art. Now you turn them on by making sure you have a little check next to right here in the box. Now currently it's showing me that I have 100%, so that means I'm not really making any change in here. Now the way this setting works is check out your filling artwork. If it's too small and you'd like it to fill in more of the space that's in there, then just increase its value. So I'm holding down the shift key and I'm hitting the up arrow key a couple times. And there you go, so it's starting to increase. Now keep in mind, after a certain point, the shapes are gonna get so large that they're gonna start overlapping each other. That's why I left that white stroke on the star, so you can kind of see how that pattern looks. All right, so if your filling art is too large, then just go ahead and back off on this. And the cool thing is, you could go less than 100% and just kind of really shrink these guys down. I'm gonna leave mine set to 100 and then just move on to the next one. So I'm gonna uncheck this guy, but I'm gonna turn on vary size. All right, so here we go now. I have the vary size thing turned on. It says after overall scaling, if any is applied, the filling art is randomly scaled up or down by the specified factor. And currently we have a factor of 4 in here. Now there's a couple different ways to work with this. You could enter in a specific value. Now if you use the increment and decrement buttons, check this out, you're getting some really subtle changes in there. So that's pretty cool. You could also put your cursor in there and now use your up and down arrow keys to get subtle changes. But if you want to get more drastic changes, hold down the shift key. All right, and that's going to increase that by a full value. All right, so now you're going to get some bigger changes going on in there. All right, so I'm going to turn this guy off, switch over to vary rotation. Now we have a variation on our rotation right here, but you don't see a value next to it. Now the value associated with it is actually going to be your seed value. So every time you hit randomize, you're going to get a new rotation. All right, so again, we're talking about that seed value. That seed's going to keep coming up over and over again. All right, so I'm going to turn off vary rotation. And we've had this guy on the whole time, multiply filling art. Currently, mine is set to 4 copies. If I turn this one off, now I'm just back to the original shape that I started off with. All right, so I'm going to turn it back on and just put my cursor in there. Now I'm going to back off on this. So we could back off down to 2 copies. And then remember, we could increase this. We could put in however many copies we need. But then once we get to a certain point, they are going to start overlapping each other. All right, so I'm going to leave mine set up at 9 because that's going to work out pretty good for me. And the last section down here at the bottom, it all has to do with how we're going to apply these settings. So the whole time I've been working with this checkbox already working right here, it says auto update. So it's going to automatically update every single time I make a change. All right, so if I turn on vary rotation, there you go. You see it happen right away over here in my artwork. If I turn on vary size, boom, there it goes again. It just happens right away. Now, if I take off some of this uniformity, there you go. So it just keeps going on every time I make a change. What if I were to switch over and change the method to outlines? So I'm going to click on it to turn it on. Now, there's a little bit of a pause because the process has to happen. All right, and there you go. So it takes some time for it to actually happen. Now, if I were to make another change, like back off on the uniformity, I have to wait for that to update again. Same for vary size and all the other ones. Every time I make a change, we actually have to wait for all that to happen. So what I'd like to do is actually uncheck auto update. And this is gonna also help me out again with really large files. All right, so what's gonna happen now is I'm gonna make some changes over here where it says vary size. I'm gonna back this off to 2. Notice there's no change in my artwork. All right, so I'm gonna back off on the uniformity. Again, no change. I'm gonna click on randomize a couple times just to get something different. And nothing is happening to my artwork. Nothing is going to happen until I come back into the panel and click on apply settings. All right, so I'm going to click on apply settings and then you see the process happen. Now the cool thing about that is you only have to wait for this process to happen once. It doesn't have to happen over and over and over again, so it kind of slows things down for me. I'd rather just uncheck this box here. It says auto update, and then whenever I'm ready to make a change, click on apply settings. All right, I'm gonna switch this back to centers because that's usually what I have it at, and auto update, there you go. So now we've gone through all the different buttons, settings, and levers we got over here in the space fill panel. Now you get all the basics down. So I'm gonna switch over to a different document that I have set up over here, and now we're gonna get into some workflow stuff and start making things a little bit more tricky. All right, so in the last document, we were using just a single space fill object. If you take a look over here on the upper left, I have 3 different objects ready to go. And these guys are going to fill in this object that I have over here, this larger object. Now it knows to automatically fill this larger object with these three guys, and that's controlled over here in the space fill panel. In the upper right section, we have this little flyout menu. When I click on it, it says space fill preferences. All right, in here, we're gonna find auto detect container object. Now this one's checked by default, so you wanna make sure that guy's turned on. Now, what this is actually controlling is it's making sure that it's gonna use the larger shape as a container all the time. It's gonna automatically select that. All right, great, so I'm gonna click on make, and you see it's gonna automatically fill it in with those guys. Now that looks really cool. I'm really happy with how that looks. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna come over here to the seed value, hit Command C, that's gonna copy it onto my clipboard. Hopefully you guys are doing a bunch of oohs and ahs over there in the comments right now for Georgie and them to see. All right, so I've got the seed value copied onto my clipboard. The reason I did that is I wanna click on randomize a couple times, and let's see if I find a better one. All right, I'm not too happy with these. That one looks okay. But nah, I really don't like these. I like that first one I had. So what I'm gonna do is go back into the seed value, right? So I have everything highlighted. I'm gonna delete that value. Then I'm gonna hit Command V or Control V if you're on a PC, and then enter or return on my keyboard to accept that change. And look, I get back that original one, that really cool one that I liked. So remember, designers, that's what I was talking about earlier when I was saying if you find a randomization that you like, you're able to save it off by just making a copy of that seed value and using it again whenever you need. All right, cool. So I got this guy set up and I really like how this looks. It looks really random. So that's one workflow. But what if we want things to be a little bit more cleaned up, a little bit more aligned, a little bit more uniform? Well, let's talk about that workflow next. Back over here in the space fill panel, I'm going to crank up the uniformity all the way to 10. All right, I'm going to back off on vary size, vary rotation. So that's going to make things line up a lot easier. All right, so I'm going to click on randomize a couple times, see what we get. I think I want to increase the size a little bit. So I'm going to click on resize all filling art. All right, so shift up arrow a couple times until I get something I like. 140 seems to work out pretty good for me. Now, again, I kind of like this one, so I'm going to copy the seed value onto my clipboard, then hit randomize a couple times. And let's see. Nope, I like the original one. So I'm going to go ahead, paste that in there, hit return. There we go. So we go back to the original one that I liked. So that's two different ways to work with it. What I wanted to show you guys was the flexibility with this tool. All right, so one way to work with it is you could come up with these crazy random variation patterns and stuff, or you could come up with something a little bit more cleaned up, a little bit more uniform, and with everything lining up a little bit better. All right, so what if you want to come in here and start making edits to your filling art? Now, currently we don't have access to it because this is a live space fill object. You could see it over here in the appearance panel. So there's a couple ways we could actually get in there and start making edits to this stuff, all right? One way is by clicking expand, and now we could go in there and make whatever changes we need to. The downside to it is, to me, it seems to be the least efficient way to work, because if, let's say, I wanted to make a change to this symbol over here in the bottom left, then I'm only gonna make change to this one and not the rest of them. Now, if that's what you actually need for your artwork, if you wanna make something a little bit more unique where it doesn't have the same pattern going across your entire object, well then that might work out great for you. Now on the upside, the great thing about expanding it is you have access to every single anchor point and path, so you could use any of your favorite vector editing tools, and you can go in there and start messing around with stuff. All right, so I'm gonna undo that. Another way to do it is by releasing this guy. All right, so it's no longer a space fill object. Then we can come over here and make changes to any of these shapes as we need. Once we're finished editing all these guys, we'll just select them again, click on make, and there you go, we'll have our pattern back. All right, now the third way is my favorite way to work, and for me, I think it's just more efficient, and the cool thing is we're gonna make use of a native feature that's been shipping with Adobe Illustrator for a really long time, and that's the symbols. All right, so if you take a look over here in the right, I have my symbols panel already set up and ready to go. Now, if you don't have your symbols panel up, you could come over here to the window menu, scroll down, and then look for symbols. Once you find symbols, just click on that, and then you're gonna see your symbols panel pop up. All right, but I already have my symbols panel up, so I'm gonna hit escape to get out of that. Now, let's release these guys. All right, what I wanna do next is create just a basic symbol. So in the tools panel, I'm gonna grab my dynamic shapes tool, I'm gonna click and drag, I'll hit the number 2 key to switch over to a dynamic circle. All right, and I'll give it a basic appearance of just a black fill, no stroke, something like that. All right, now for those of you guys that don't know how to make a symbol, it's really easy. You just want to make sure you have your symbols panel up, and you just want to click and drag your artwork into the panel, and then you see that little plus symbol, then release. All right, now it's going to give you the opportunity to name that symbol. All right, so I'm going to name this guy space fill, hit tab. All right, next we have export type, and it's a little drop down menu. All right, if you were going to export this symbol for, let's say, an animation, then you would leave it set to movie clip. But because I'm going to use this for a print project, I'm going to switch it over to graphic and click OK. Now, check this out. Over here on my little artwork, I have a crosshairs right in the center, and that lets me know that I've created a symbol. All right, so this works the same way as the shapes do. All right, you select both of them, click on make, and there you go. So now you filled it in with this little polka dot pattern. Actually, it's kind of big, so let me back off on this guy. And let me add a couple copies in here, and I'll click on randomize, see what we get. All right, cool. I just wanted a basic pattern, everything kind of lined up. That looks pretty good. All right, so I show this to my client. My client thinks, oh, this is great, but you know what? I'm tired of polka dots. I'm thinking about something with a little bit more flourish. You think you could come up with something? And of course, I'm going to say, sure, no problem. So how do we edit this symbol? And check this out. What I like about it is I don't even have to have my artwork selected. I just deselected my artwork. All we're doing is focusing on the symbol. And this is what I like about it. This is where I'm talking about the efficiency of this all. All right, back in the symbols panel, I'm going to double click on this space fill symbol. And now I have access to the symbol. Now we're just dealing with the symbol. We're now just in the symbol editing space. All right, so I'm going to zoom in on this guy. Nice, clean zoom right in there. All right, I'm going to select this artwork. And now I can just edit this however I want. All right, on this machine, I have ColliderScribe installed. So I'm going to come over here to the window menu, scroll down, and find ColliderScribe. Now, if you don't have ColliderScribe installed on your machine, just head over to astutegraphics.com. And you could download and try ColliderScribe for 14 days for free. All right, what I'm looking for is ColliderScribe panel. All right, I'm gonna bring this guy up because on here there's this awesome feature that's gonna allow me to select all the handles on my selected path. So when I click on that, check this out, I got these little snowballs, and all I gotta do is click and drag, and it's gonna move all the Bezier handles that are on that path for me at the same time. All right, there you go, I'm gonna release, and then just back off a little bit. Now, for those of you folks visiting us on the live audience, make sure you put in any questions you have over in the comment right now, or over in the chat, or you could bring them up at the end of the demo, but you know, in case you guys have any questions on what I just did there. All right, so we've already edited our symbol. Remember when we came into this editing symbol mode, we had a polka dot handbag. So now how do we get out of here and go back to our handbag? What you want to do is just double click on the artboard. And there you go, look, our handbag's already updated. I don't even have it selected or anything. Everything's just updated in real time. Isn't that awesome? Hopefully you folks are digging it. Throw some comments in the chats for us. All right, cool. So I wanna continue to work with this. You know me, I'm all about my workflow. So I'm gonna make some changes in here. Now let's go back and edit the symbol some more. I'm gonna double click on this guy. I'll select my symbol. All right, so let's make a color change. I'm gonna switch over to one of those greens that we were using earlier. Actually, maybe a darker green, because I'm gonna drop the opacity in a little bit. Over here in the upper right, back in the appearance panel, remember, this is where all the power is at, all right? So I'm gonna click on opacity. Now I'm gonna change the blending mode over to multiply. And over here where it says opacity, I'm gonna back off on this. You know, somewhere in the high 70s is fine. Play around with it. Remember, it's a symbol, so you could always come back and edit it. That's why I like working with it in this mode. All right, so now I'm gonna back out of here by double-clicking on the artboard. And there you go, check this out. Now it's actually working with my artwork a little bit better. So for me, this is a better mock-up representation than what I had earlier. I'm gonna be a lot more proud to show this to my client than what I had before. All right, so there you go, folks. A couple easy workflows working with this and the native symbols that actually ship with Adobe Illustrator. So we started thinking, what other native features is Spacefill going to work really well with? Well, back in the office, they started playing around with this guy over here. So we have this whiskey glass up. Now, if you check this out, this is all vectors, 100% vectors you see here, except for that bitmap image in the back. Now, what's going on here is we have this ice cube set up here. And wherever I click and drag it to, if you notice, we have this awesome reflection that's moving along with it, right? It's some little Adobe magic going on in there. Now, how is this happening? Check this out. Come over here to the upper right again. Remember the appearance panel? Like I said earlier, this is where all the power is. If you don't have your appearance panel up, you're messing up. All right, so at the top, it says layer, and it says effects. So that means there's a live effect applied to the layer, and anything we put inside of this layer, it's gonna have the same effect applied to it. All right, so I'm gonna click on layer, and it shows us that we actually have a transform live effect applied to it. So I'm gonna click on transform, and now I'm gonna give you guys access to, this is all the settings. So if you guys wanna do the reflect one, go ahead and take a screenshot. And now I'm gonna take a little pause, give a little shout out to Georgie, because she wanted to make sure I gave a long pause for you guys. All right, you should have your screenshot. You good? All right, I'm back out of here. All right, great. So now we're back to this guy, right? Now, remember, wherever I move this guy to, our little reflection updates. So I want to see, is Spacefill going to honor this live effect? All right, so I'm going to select my vectors. I got both of them selected right there. Then click on Make. All right, and check that out. All right, well, the ice doesn't look all that great. But check this out. Over here at the bottom, our reflection is set up. It looks really cool, right? So it's actually able to respect our native live effects that ship with Adobe Illustrator. All right, so back into workflow mode. All right, let's come back into the panel. I'm going to make some changes in here. What does it say here? Multiply filling art, 11 copies. That means I have 11 ice cubes. Now, I don't want to wake up and find 11 ice cubes in my whiskey, so I'm going to back off on that. I'm going to put 4 ice cubes. Actually, that's still probably too many, but we'll do 4 because it fills up the whiskey glass nicely. Now, I like how that looks, so I'm going to make a copy of this just in case. And I'll click on, let's see, vary size. There we go. That looks kind of crazy. I'll click on randomize a couple times. There we go. Now we're getting something a little bit better. And you just click on this. There we go. I like how this one looks. So again, I want to copy that seed because I like this one better than the one I originally had. And let's see if I find any other ones that I like. Let's see. That one actually looks great. I'm going to go with that one. I'm not going to replace it. I like this one better than the one I have copied onto my clipboard. So you notice that our reflection is updated. It looks really cool. We have this awesome ice effect in there, and it was all done using this new space fill feature that's part of ColliderScribe 2 by Astute Graphics. And there you have it, folks. That's the demo we had prepared for you guys today. If you have to take off, we really appreciate you guys coming out and checking us out.